Hello everyone, it's Petko Aleksandrov from Trading Academy, and today I'll be showing you how you can stake Tezos using the Ledger Live app, and I will demonstrate it step by step. Ledger is one of the safest wallets and more people are using it, but not everyone knows that actually they can earn passive income from keeping their tokens in their hardware wallet. So if I am a token holder of Tezos, I can delegate the validation rights to other token holders that are known as validators, but I won't be transferring ownership of my tokens. The good thing here is that while I am delegating my Tezos, is completely liquid. This means that there is no locking period. I can move my Tezos at any moment. As well, it is said that there is no risk of delegating the Tezos when using the Ledger Live device. The only risk is that I won't be getting my rewards. This is why choosing carefully the validator is essential. And I would suggest you always to go with the validator that offers the highest rewards, because if too many people choose him, then he might not be able to do it. So let me open the app now and I will show you how it works. What I have here are different accounts where I store Bitcoin, Ethereum. I have Stellar, Litecoin, Bitcoin Cash, Tezos. Now if I tap on my Tezos account, I have totally 255.37 Tezos, which equals to $887 based on the price where Tezos is today. And on the top, you see that I have the option to earn rewards. You can earn rewards by delegating your account. I will tap on that, and here we have three important things to note. Delegated accounts remain yours. And if we compare the information from the official website, you can see that the token holders can delegate their validation rights to other token holders called validators without transferring ownership. And the second important thing is that we remain with liquid assets. In other words, we don't have freezing periods or locking periods like what we have with the earn section on crypto.com. At any moment, we can exchange, move, or transfer the tokens. And the last thing is they state that there is no risk when you are delegating the tokens. The only risk is not to get your rewards. Now I will tap on delegate to earn rewards, and you will see that it will give me automatically a delegator called Figment that offers 5.69% yearly reward. But the better thing you should do is to choose a delegator by yourself. So I will tap on the pencil and I will see all of the delegators. And here we see estimated yield, or this is the reward. And you can go through all of them, but the better thing you can do is to open the website called My Tezos Baker. And I usually prefer to open it from my computer, not from the phone, because I can see clearly the parameters. We have the fee, which varies a lot. So if I click on fee, I can arrange it according to the fees. On the top, I can see the ones that have the lowest fees. However, I never aim at the lowest fees. Anything between 5 and 6 works well for me. And if the fee is that low, probably there is a reason for it. And you can see that some of the first ones have a low efficiency. So I usually go with bakers that have a fee somewhere 5 to 6% and are at least for a year on the market. Then I have the staking yield. Again, not a good idea to look always for the highest yields, but of course anything above 5 would work great. then we have the efficiency, then we have the capacity. So you can see that most of them are in red, which means that they might not accept any more Tezos to stake, and their available capacity is actually on negative. And if you go with a baker that has run out of capacity, then you take the risk. They might not be able to complete and pay you back the promised rewards, okay? And in the last column, we have the country, which doesn't talk a lot, but you can have an idea from where the baker is. All right, so what you need to do is to make your own research. You can visit their Twitter profiles or other social media, look for reviews and see which are the ones that you can trust. I will go now for the purpose of this video and for the purpose of staking this Tezos account with the stake and bake. They have 5% fee, which is just fine for me. They've been on the market since November 2019 and they have staking yield of 5.92, which is very close to the maximum, and we have good efficiency. They're from Switzerland and you can see that they have some available capacity, so I will go with them. Now let me open the same website on the phone. Here it is, and I will look for stake and bake. Here it is, 5%. You can see the same information. It's the very same thing, right? It's the same website. Just looking at it from the computer, it's much easier and I can see the bigger picture. I will tap on it, and when opening, you will see that I have their address. Starts with TZ and ends on 9M. And below I have some more information about that baker. But what I need to do right here is to copy the address, all right? So I will have the address where I will be sending the delegation rights. And I will open the app now. I will tap again on delegate to earn. Now again, the Ledger Live app gives me another baker by default, but I will tap on the pencil to choose the one I want. Now here you can look for them in the list, but the better thing you can do is add custom validator, and I will paste the address from the website and I will tap on confirm validation. And here is the same icon with the delicious steak, and it shows the estimated yield per year, and I will tap on continue, and now I need to connect to my Nano X. It will take just a couple of seconds to connect it, and it requires confirmation from the device itself. Once I do that, it will display the both addresses, okay? So it will show the address from the stake and bake, and it will show as well my public address, which is the source, and then I will be just confirming it from the device. As you can see, it says on your device, please confirm to finalize the operation, and it's loading, takes a few more seconds, and here it is, delegation sent. And what you can see here, you should earn your first rewards in around 40 days, depending on the validator, and then I will see the results. Right here, I have some more details, like the date, the hour, the network fee, which is about 20 cents, very small fee, and from my address to the address of the delegator. And if I go back to the portfolio, I can see the delegation as actual transaction, and you can see that it was delegated. It's easy to keep track of what I have done, if I'm delegating or if I'm staking more accounts. So now the Tezos actually stays into my account. It's on my ledger. I have just delegated it to a baker, and I will get rewards for it. All right, guys, so this is how easy it is to delegate your Tezos using the Ledger live app, connecting it to the Ledger Nano X I'm using. And if you're not familiar with it, there is the Ledger Nano S as well. I have made a video for both of them, so if you wonder which one would work better for you, then you can have a look at it. But if you are a beginner who is just starting out and you want to test, or you are buying your first cryptocurrencies for a couple of $100, for example, I don't think it's worthy buying a Ledger. Probably on a later stage when you have at least a couple of $1,000 in value, then I think it is worthy having a Ledger, so you will store your cryptocurrency safe. All right, that's something very important. If you are planning anyway to buy a Ledger, I would suggest you to go from the official website. There is an affiliate link below in the description if you want to use it. And if you have any questions about staking Tezos on the Ledger Live app or anything that I would be useful to you, please write in the comments below. I would be super happy to answer your questions, if I can, of course. And if you have found the video useful, thumbs up, and I will see you guys in the next video. Cheers!